How's that?
Okay.
Huh? Okay.
Okay. And then you draw the main action line. There. The main action line. In a sense, it already exists. Now, what is very important is the proportion. The figure should be 8 heads tall. A lot of students, they start real big, and then they start with size 16, they end up with size 3. You gotta be consistent. The middle is the middle, that's about there.
Okay.
Now, there's your action line. You notice I'm keeping it light, so that I'm able to change it. All right, now I look for the essential parts. Okay, the rib cage, the pelvis, which is hidden in there. All right, the arm and the weight. This thing comes over here. This over here. This is about like that. There. See, now I notice I'm knocking myself out to see to it that I get the feet on the page. Now, just to get the feet on the page down here is not enough. You should create some kind of a platform. So, there. See that? Okay, now I'm going to look for parts. I'm going to use the line for a while, and that's called articulation. Now, the parts. All right, let's start. All right, there's the rib cage. There's the... teres major, okay. Latus most dorsi, part of the breast. Rib cage comes through here, like there's a little bit of it showing over there. And there's your external oblique, and there's your upper and lower stomach. All right, now there's the crest of the ilium. See the bone over there? Okay, then the thigh. This overlaps this. Okay, now here's the medius. There's the great trochanter. Okay, the medius comes in there like this. It's in two parts. Then there's the maximus, comes in there like this. Okay. Then this portion you see coming around here, that's the tensor. Now I'm constructing this according to the knowledge that I've gained through the last 100 years. Okay, now, not too far off. Okay, now there's a muscle, the vastus lateralis. Okay, and then the rectus femoris comes in there. This is part of the vastus lateralis in there. Then there's the tendinous portion of the kneecap, fat pad of the knee, and then your lower leg. Okay, now this thing inserts between this muscle and the biceps femoris, the maximus inserts between these two. Okay, now then the short head comes around here, biceps femoris short head. Okay, now on the other side is the semitendinosus. You see a little bit of it. And then there's the space in between, right in there. All right. Then there's the gastrocnemius calf muscles to you. And then, okay. Achilles tendon, Achilles heel. The outside bone is low, the inside bone is high. I'll show you in a minute on the other side. Okay, now then there's generally the drive of this leg. Now unless you get the drive, it looks weak. Okay, okay, now here's the other leg. Quickly here now, see. There it is again. See, it has to fit from the other side. Let me see now. There's a little bit showing there, the maximus, which comes through here. That means this should be lower, a little bit lower. Okay, now then, there's a muscle called the sartorius, which starts, well, we can't see the rest of the ilium. And then it comes down here like this, it comes through here, and it's attached to the tibia bone. Okay, there's the rectus femoris, tendinous portion of the kneecap, fat pad, and tibia bone, and here we are again. There's your calf, here's this tendinous portion, Achilles tendon. Now the inside bone is high. All right, and then this foot comes out about like that. Okay, now we carry on. Let's see. This is too high. This has to come lower. There. Okay. Now, all right, there's the breast. There's the latissimus dorsi, and there your shoulder blade comes through here. All right, then your spine. Now, what happens to the spine is this. This is, it doesn't matter. If it's a stool, fine. If you want to make it something else, fine. I personally prefer something, a rock or anything, or a grate. Okay. Now, the complete action before we revisit all this. There's the back of the neck. There's the seventh cervical vertebrae, trapezius, deltoid, trapezius on this side, all right, and then we see the front, the side which becomes the front of the shoulder blade, scapula to you, all right, and then we look at these forms over here. This should be a little bit higher. Okay, now I notice here, for the simple reason that I made this very tall, I'm just a little bit short. Don't live with anything that's short. Yeah. Immediately change it. There, immediately, all right? This is a little short, just a little bit. And you know, I knew that when I started, and then I thought, well, I'm gonna let it go because so I can make a point of it. So here we are. There. Now it looks as though it could work. Okay. This is a little stronger in there. There. Okay, now. The spine. All right, first, let's get this hair done. You gotta get generally the feeling of the hairdo, generally, but don't waste a lot of time on it. Don't do a Marcel job on it. You know, some people then spend all their time noodling up here and then they miss the action. Just keep going. Okay, now, here, right there, so many people misunderstand this. They don't draw the back of the neck, you see? This is the back of the neck. Okay, now let's draw that center line, which is all important here. Here's this, it's like a bun almost. Something like this. Okay, now, this is what would happen there now. There's a plane here like this, yeah? That goes under, all right? Now, over there, it's something like that. Simplify it, make it a bun. See that? All right, then here's the seventh cervical vertebrae. Here's the rib cage from the back. Okay, now our center line here, up here would be like this. See, it goes through there, then the plane turn changes there, then it comes out there, then it changes in there, then it comes out this way, then across the seventh cervical vertebrae, the bone, and then the back of the rib cage up to there. Then it switches again. Then comes the lumbar region, all right, still a little higher, then the sacrum, the sacrum is in there. See? So look how many plane changes there are. Okay? Alright. Now then here, this area looks about like this. Alright, this comes in there. And then your this sticks way out. There's a fly over there. I don't know if somebody wants to knock it off. Okay. You got it? Alright, now here are other things that should happen. You also have to be design conscious and composition conscious. Now, this line shoots up to there. See? In other words, that's a definite decided angle. Okay, now we have planes. I like this. Now we must have planes. Through in here, about through here, and through there, is a plane turn. Now watch this. There, all this. Through here, and through there. That's a side plane. Now this is the back. So it is, in a sense, this is round, like a cylinder. It's like a cylinder, like this. However, it's not just one cylinder, it's two. One, two. And then this is the side. And there's a third one with the breast area. Okay. Now you have to go still further. All right, first of all, this is all dark over here. Because this is hidden. This form here, as the tarsus major, latus metatarsi, and then right there's the external oblique. See the external oblique coming through there? There's the crest of the ilium. See, now all this, this is closest to us. This is way up in the air. Now, with the side light, it makes all this in shadow back here. See, all that is a shadow area, all right? Including this leg. This is all a shadow area, but we'll revisit this. Now here then, there's our general plane turn, right in there, right through in there, and in there, and another one in there. Okay, now so far so good, but that's not enough. Now you notice this side, this looks flat. Okay, let's keep going now. Right. Breast. Now we define this right in there is usually very dark because it doesn't catch any light. Okay. Now this has to be, there's our deltoid is in there. And then our triceps comes in there about like this. And then you see the other side. Now if it's a woman, you can't make it too muscular. Just enough to show that you know what you're doing. Okay. Now then here, see, notice the tendinous portion comes around like this, and then this comes in front of this. All right, now this is all very dark. As it goes under, it gets to be very dark. There's your elbow area. And then this part comes in there like this. This is in front, and this is in front of that. See, so it's constantly looking and redeveloping. Okay, the rib cage shows part of the rib cage in there. Now here's the stomach area, which comes around like this. Darkest dark next to the lightest light, and then this casts a shadow onto the arm. You see, but this contour is ever so important. See. Now this is too light here. See, this has to be toned down a little. All right, now the shadow area continues to here. See that? There. The tensor area. All right, now the medius. Look at the medius. See? You see the way this bulges out over there? And then here's the great trochanter, like this. All right. Now, right about there, there's a dark. Okay. Then this turns away, and back in there, this turns away. We darken this, now we've got to show a thickness over there. comes in like this, see? But then it switches again, see? But right there, see, this becomes like a cone. You see, in a sense, it's like this. Now the cone, when the light comes from over here, it doesn't get any light, see? But then it switches to another area there. It does get light, okay. Now, this is light, this is dark, this is very dark, and then you have to explain the muscle, and then right there, see, then you have to explain this, see? All right, now over here, there's a great trochanter. Just show that you understand it without making it too obvious. Okay. Now we have to work to the lights. See? We tone this side down. We tone the sides down so that the light is in the middle. All right. Yeah, this comes like this. This then comes out like this and like this. Now look what happens here. I just want to bring out some of these things here. This is in front of that. This is in front of that. This is in back of this. This is in back of this. This is in front. See, look for that, for these overlaps. These overlaps is what give you a little bit bigger over there. Why? Okay, now, quickly here, there's a cast shadow in there, and that shadow is cast from this leg. Now, there has to be enough dark here, and very much dark here, to give a reason for that cast shadow. All right, this is higher. And now we're getting it. This bigger, this comes out further. This, okay, now up here. I don't want to lose sight of this. Now, you see that turn over there? That's the same as this, or this, the same. Okay, now all this is dark. The whole thing is dark, because it turns away. It's like this. This, and this, and this. It's the same. All right, then there's your ear. We're not going to go into this too much because we don't have that much time. Okay, then there's your... sternocleidomastoid. All right, then the neck comes up in there like this. And then the hair. All right, then the jawbone goes off into the distance there. And then this is generally about like this. Okay, this plane over here. Now, this is what so many students leave out. This part of the neck. Okay. Now then, as you see, there's your trapezius over there. Now here we are over here. Over here. Okay, now, then we have a muscle here that goes across there. It's part of the trapezius. Okay, here's the shoulder blade. Shaped about like that, right? But now we have to shade it. See? Now we see this over here, over there. Did you notice when she coughed how it brought out this part over here? Okay, now, all right, so this becomes a half-tone area, not too dark, but just a half-tone. All right. Now, this is not light. See, so many people think that area is light. It goes across like this. See? As it goes over the mountain there, it gets dark. It's not light. So many students, they always leave that top light. It isn't light. Okay. Now, over here then, see, now this turns. A 10% turn. And here, too. This turns. And then your external oblique is about like this. And then your sacrum and your lumbar region. Okay, now then we see some of these vertebrae in there. Okay, of the shoulder blade over there. And again, see, now this turns away. All this turns away. See here too, see, here. This is in the back, and this is in the front. Now you gotta have a tone there, so the cylinder goes around. You can't just shade this thing on one side and then leave it here, because this then becomes flat. Are we running out of time? Should we give her a rest?
What?
I mean, is this, you think we've gone far enough? Huh? All right. So, we've gone far enough? Okay, we've gone far enough. Fade out. Are you zooming in and out?
See,
on the other side, it's pushing the button. Yeah, 1 minute. Huh? You want to time me?
Yeah, forgot it.
Say when. Go ahead.
Go. Is the voice coming through? Huh?
one there. See, you want me over here? Huh? To scale it, right? Okay. Muscles, planes, posterior, planes. Is that enough? No, I got enough. Okay, I'll get out of here. So don't stay on too long. Don't stay on it too long. Huh? Hey. Get there. Say when, my back is beginning to hurt. Because while you're at it, I have one more for you to shoot. Okay.
Thank you.
Oh, well done.